I'm going to talk to you about selling equipment on eBay or just finding out what the value of something is. Over the years, I've bought and sold a lot of equipment. I used to take my equipment in and resell it at the music store. They'll give you maybe half of what it's worth. And if you check on eBay, you can tell whether you're getting a good deal or not. But usually, trading something in, you're going to get a whole lot less than if you sold it outright. What I do, I have a lot of equipment that I go through. I'll buy something. If it's not right, I return it, get something else. If it works the way it should, I do a review on it, and I'll keep it a couple months, do a couple videos, and then I'll sell it on eBay. It's a good idea, before you buy equipment, to check out what it's worth used. If you see a lot of something on eBay for resale and the price is a whole lot less than what you paid for it, not a good sign. You should be seeing reasonable resale values on items, and newer items, you shouldn't see a flood of that item for sale. If you do, there's usually something wrong with that. Gonna walk you through pricing something on eBay and how I go about getting my initial listings set up. And as usual, please like, subscribe, and share to your friends. Thank you so much. Bye. I'm going to show you how to find out what something's worth to sell it on eBay or just for your own personal knowledge. So the first thing you're going to do is go to ebay.com, and then in the search bar you're going to want to type the item that you're looking for. Let's say I want to know how much my Apogee Duet is worth. So I will type in Apogee Duet and Apogee Duet 2, and they're going to show me what's for sale. You're going to go over to the left-hand side column. You want to select used, because you're going to sell something used. And I always select US only. And then right here, you're going to either select sold listings or completed listings. So it doesn't matter. The completed is going to show you everything that's ended, whether it's sold or not. The sold will show you what's actually been sold. So here are what that item has sold for. And what I'll do, I'll look for the item that sold for the most, and I'll look at that to see the pictures that they've used, how they described their item, how they listed it, and it'll give me a lot of information as to how to list mine. So this one sold for $382. I'm going to look at the original listing. And here it is. Okay, you can see they have good pictures of the item. And that looks pretty good. So if I were to sell this, I would probably go ahead and I would click that I have one to sell, and I would sell now, and I would use this listing as my template. Make sure you go in and change everything that you don't want. Like right here, it says used once, perfect condition. The description there, you're going to want to change. All of this, I would leave the same. So let's go back. And now if you're trying to decide what you could possibly get for this as a trade-in, the trade-in value is usually going to be pretty low, but usually what they do is take the lowest and the highest and they average them out. So these look like $275 to $350. Now say you're looking for something that's non-music. I want to know, let's see what I could sell my iPad Pro for. See, 12.9. And again, I'm going to go over and select the specifics. Okay, iPad Pro, second generation. Okay, and want to make sure you select used. And I want to make sure it's US only and sold listings. Okay, here is what these have sold for. The last one was October 9th. So it looks like it's worth about $900. That's how you would check out prices on something that you're wanting to know what it's worth. This is how I usually judge what to sell my items for. Now, nothing is written in stone. Everyone does things differently, but this is just how I do it. The next time I have something for sale that I list on eBay, if you'd like, I can go ahead and post that. Just let me know down in the description if that would be helpful for you or not. And please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you so much. Bye.